In 1966, a physicist named Peter Higgs wrote the paper Spontaneous Symmetry Breakdown Without Massless Bosons and submitted it to the Journal of Physics Letters. It was rejected. But 47 years later, in 2013, he received the Nobel Prize in Physics after CERN confirmed the existence of Higgs boson, as predicted in that paper. Every year, thousands of valuable papers are rejected, and many of them are never published anywhere because a century-old ecosystem dominates the research publication industry. Many scientists agree that this system is flawed and slows down the progression of science. For example, due to space limitations, journals tend to limit their scopes to narrow disciplines. But in a world so complex and interrelated, such classifications may not be accurate anymore and can exclude many novel interdisciplinary studies. Even online journals that do not have such limitations still follow this old tradition. Generally, the space limitations have forced journal editors to make difficult decisions to accept or reject several manuscripts each year. And this accept-reject standard has become the main indicator for the quality and value of scientific studies. Yeah, a binary quality measure for such complex and diverse artifacts. Not only do manuscripts fall on a spectrum of quality levels, but also there are different dimensions for their quality. A well-written paper may have no novel contribution, and a novel idea might not have been tested or proved rigorously. A diligent economist is not necessarily a great writer, too. Fortunately, there is an alternative to this obsolete paradigm. PaperScore, the first decentralized peer-reviewed journal, does not accept or reject manuscripts, but rather gives them rating scores across multiple dimensions based on reviewers' inputs. And at the end, it is up to the authors, not the editors, to decide whether or not to publish their manuscript along with the reviewers' comments and scores. Moreover, PaperScore is not limited to any field of study and can publish papers in all areas. It just tags them with keywords, so the readers can easily find the papers they want. This obviates the need for editors to decide if a manuscript falls under the scope of the journal. But of course, we still need editors to find suitable reviewers, right? No, we don't. PaperScore's algorithm finds potential reviewers using references, keywords, and then the small word phenomenon. Let me elaborate. First, a submitted manuscript is referred to a few potential reviewers based on its keywords and references. Then, those who cannot or do not want to review the manuscript can refer it to potentially more relevant reviewers. The new ones can do the same, and each chain most likely leads to expert reviewers who are able and willing to review the manuscript on at least one aspect. Furthermore, PaperScore acknowledges accurate and timely reviews through public reviewer points while keeping the reviewers anonymous. Oh, by the way, remember how the traditional journals incentivize reviewers to review manuscripts thoroughly and in time? Me neither. Try PaperScore, the future of science.